Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let's take a look at all that Spotlight can do on your Mac. So Spotlight is a keyboard-based multi-tool on your Mac that can be used for all sorts of different things. You can launch it in the menu bar by clicking on the Spotlight icon, like this. But you can also launch it using the keyboard with Command Space. When you first bring it up, it's just a single line text field like this, and you can use it to search for things, a lot of different things. For instance, you could use it to search for a file like this. And you'll see results appear below. It's going to find files that have what you typed in the name of the file, but it's also going to look for files that have that text in the contents of the file. When you do a simple search like this, you can use your pointer and simply click on the file that you want to open, and it will just open the file. You could also use your keyboard, so the down arrow will start going through the content that's there, and with the selection highlighted, you can press return, and it will open up that document. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MACMOST at Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. When you first bring up Spotlight, this is kind of a universal search here. It'll do anything that Spotlight does in this mode. So you can search for files like I just showed you, but it'll also find content in your other data, things that aren't files. For instance, if I search for restaurant like that, it will find files with that in it, but it will also find email messages. You can see the first result there is actually an email message. You can see the little icon there to the left. And if I press return here, it will launch the mail app and go to that message. It'll do the same thing to find messages in the Messages app or events in the Calendar app like that. We'll find items in the Reminders app like that. It'll even search inside of your Photos library for something. So, for instance, I can search for giraffe, and it'll find lots of files that match that as well. But if I go further down here, you can see it finds a result in the Photos app too. And this isn't a photo that's labeled giraffe. This is a photo that just happens to have a giraffe in it, and Spotlight can tell that from looking at the photo. You can even search inside your Safari bookmarks and history like this, and you can go right to that bookmark or history item. You could also search for settings. So for instance, if I search for hover, I could quickly get to the hover text or hover typing settings in system settings. So universal mode in Spotlight, what you get when you just use Command Space, is very powerful. And you can do most things that you can do in Spotlight in this mode. And I'm going to show you some more specific examples later on. But let's move on to the four very specific modes of Spotlight. You'll see these if you bring up Spotlight and then move the pointer like this, or if you just click on the icon in the menu bar, and they show these four specific modes. First is Applications, and you could see there's a keyboard shortcut there, Command 1, to take you to that. But you could also click on this icon here in your dock to go to it. This icon would have replaced Launchpad if you had that in the dock previously. The easiest way to bring it up with the keyboard is Command Space, and while still holding Command down, then press 1, and it goes into Applications mode. And this is a search mode, just like the universal search mode, but it's only going to show you applications as results. So if we start typing something, like I'll type the letter P, it will show me the applications that start with the letter P or have some other match. So for instance, you can see QuickTime Player, the second word starting with P, that shows up here as well. A note, you can change this from icon view to list view right here if you want, but either way, you can use the arrow keys to move around and select an app that you want, and then simply press return to launch that app like that. But I think the way most people will use this is simply to just start typing the name of the app until the app is the first item there, and then just press return and it will launch that app. And note, you can do the same with universal search. You don't have to go into apps mode to do this. If I type CALC here, it's going to come up with calculator as the first selection, and then I can press return. But if you want to make sure you're only launching apps, going into app mode is the best way to do that. They can also narrow things down by category. Here you've got a list of suggestions at the top, so it's trying to predict what it is you're about to launch. And then you've got these categories here. You can click here and you'll see it gives you the category photo and video, and you could see the suggestions here. You can use escape to go back. Now let's take a look at the second mode. This is command 2, or click on this button, and this is just files. If you know you want to just find a file, you can go into this mode with command space and then command 2. And here it's going to show you suggestions at the top. It's going to show you recently opened files below that. And you can also select categories here at the top. Most of the time, you're just going to start to type the name of the file like that and see what it comes up with. Like with apps, you can switch to list mode, which might be more useful as you get all this information about each file. Here, you also get a clue by looking at the icon on the left. You'll see the document icon and then the app that's set to open this one by default. You can use the arrow keys to navigate around in here and press return to open this file. You can also do some other things with the current selection. If you use command R, for instance, it will take you to the file instead of opening it. Another thing you could do is you could press the space bar to use quick look to preview the file. You press space bar again to dismiss it, go to another file, space bar to preview it again. But you could also move quick look off to the side and then continue to use the up and down arrows to preview the file while you also have Spotlight still open. Now in this mode, you could also narrow down by type. For instance, if I know I want to open a numbers document, I can just click on numbers here and it is only going to show me results that will be opened by that app. There's a shortcut for that. That's to use slash, the forward slash, and then just start typing the name of the app like that. Once you see it selected, press return. So I can now start searching based on both the app and the name or contents. Some of these are app names like numbers. Others are things like PDF, a file type. But another thing you could do here is use slash and then type the folder. If you know, for instance, that the file is in a folder called examples, I could start typing that. It's going to show me folders like that. And I could move with the arrow keys up and down through them. And if I know this is the right folder, the examples folder in my documents folder, I can press return and it's going to narrow down my results based on that. So I can see the files that are in examples. So if I now search further with some text, you'll see I get results there, both for the name and the contents. And some quick advanced tips here. If you do name colon, then it's only going to find things where that's in the name. And if you want to use and or not, you can do them, just use all capitals. So if I do and name document like that, you could see it gives me results like that. But if I do or like that, then you could see it's going to give me things that have test or document in the title. And if I use not, you could see it'll give me things that have test in the name, but not things that have document in the name. So now we come to the third mode, which is actions. And actions are special things that you could do right from Spotlight. When you just go to actions here, you get a big list starting with suggestions and then broken up in categories, usually by app. So you get an idea of what's possible. And all you need to do is just start typing the name of the action. So for instance, if I wanted to start a timer, you can see start timer there. I could also just type timer and you could see it figures out that's the most likely one. And then I press return. And now Spotlight's going to prompt me for a duration. So I could say 10 minutes. And if I press return, it's going to start the timer. You could see it up here. The timer is actually running in the clock app. Some other examples are type alarm. And you see, you can add an alarm for a time and give it a name. You can see the first suggestion right there is send message. And you can use that and you could type the message and then who you want it to go to. And of course, the messages app is going to be used to send this, but you could do it from Spotlight without even opening up the messages app. If I type email, you see, I could also send an email with a subject and to whoever I want without opening the mail app. You can search for a calendar and you can see you can create a new calendar event. It's the second one here, like that. You give it a title, you can give it a start time and an end time, and I'll add it without having to go to calendar right now. You could even control your files and folders this way. For instance, here I've got this file right here. I'm going to select it. Now, instead of dragging and dropping it to this other folder called demo, I'm going to use Spotlight. I'm going to do command 3 to go to actions, and I'm going to type move. You can see I can move file and press return. Now, it will show current selection and actually list the current selection underneath. I could just press return to accept that. And now it's going to ask for folder. I'm going to start typing the name of a folder, and I can see the one I want to move to right there. I can press return to select that, and then return again will move the file. Now note something when you go to the actions section. There's this thing on the right that says add quick keys. For creating a new event, I could say CNE for calendar new event, and press return. Now I don't have to type new event to get here. I can just type CNE, and it knows this is the one I want. And in fact, it will work in the regular universal mode of Spotlight search. You can see it brings that up first. Note also that Start Timer has a set of quick keys there, ST, and I didn't even apply that. It just noticed I was using it, so it picked out some quick keys for me. But I can click on it and change it if I want. You can make your own by going into Shortcuts. And then with any shortcut, like I'll go into this one, if I go to Details here, I can choose to Show in Spotlight. And I can run this shortcut here from Spotlight Actions. So I'll do Command Space, Command 3, and start typing image, and there's image of the day, my shortcut, which I can run and even assign a quick key to. And if you really want to get into it, you can define input fields in your shortcut as well. So Spotlight prompts you for information and then performs the action, just like sending a message or setting a reminder. Now let's look at the fourth mode of Spotlight, and that is clipboard. And this gives you a history of your clipboard. So let's add things to the clipboard. So in this page's document, I will copy some text here, I'll copy some other text here, and I will copy some other text here. Now let's go into Spotlight, and I'll use Command 4 to go to Clipboard, and you can see each of those things has been saved in a history here. And you can recall any of them by just using the arrow keys or clicking, and it will actually paste it into whatever it is you're working on. You could also click this button here to the right to make it the current clipboard. And you could also control click, right click, or two finger click on any of these to paste, copy, in other words, make it the current item or delete that item. You can also click on the three dots here and clear all of the history. It even works with images. I can select an area of this image, Command C to copy. And if I look in Spotlight history, you could see it's saved that image there. So you could use it to copy and paste things from graphic to graphic. And it works with files. I could select this file, Command C to copy, go into another folder, and you know, of course, I could Command V to paste a copy in here. And notice that the file is also saved in this history. The history is only saved for 8 hours. It tries to avoid saving passwords in here at all. But it's super handy to have, especially if you just need the very basics of a clipboard manager. Now you've got that built into macOS and you don't need a third-party app for that. Although there are a lot of great clipboard managers out there that do other things as well. So beyond the four modes of Spotlight, Spotlight still does a lot of other things, things that it has done for years. So if I bring it up just with a command space, I can still do math calculations here. You could do something simple like this, and you could see how it gives you a result. But you could actually do pretty complex things. Like for instance, if I wanted to use parentheses to get a result like that, I could. You can do conversions in Spotlight. So for instance, I could say 60 cm for centimeters, and it will convert to inches. But I could also do, say, as feet, and it'll give me it in feet. It'll even do multi-unit conversions. So 30 mpg, miles per gallon, will convert to 7.84 liters per 100 kilometers. And it could do currency conversions as well. If I type $100, it'll convert it to euros. If I did 100 and then typed euro like that, it'll give me dollars. You can use different currencies like that. And it's looking this up real time. So this is pretty up to date as well. And speaking of looking things up, you can look up stock prices by just typing the symbol like that. You can get weather by just typing weather and you'll see it appear there. Or type in and the name of a city like that. You can type words like that And if it's a long enough, uncommon enough word, it's going to assume you want a definition like that. Otherwise, for more common words, you could type define, and that'll put the definition up there at the top. Otherwise, you would have to scroll down to get to it. Another handy one is time in, and then give it a city, and it'll tell you the current time there. You can look up flights. By typing the flight number like that, you can see the results right there. And if I press return over that, you could see I get all sorts of information and I'm still right here in Spotlight. You can get sports scores by typing the name of the team. If you type showtimes, then you'll find movie showtimes here. So like that, and it'll tell you local showtimes as well as other information about the movie. You can look up locations like that, and you can see you get a link to the Maps app. Now, if you just want to do a web search, you can start it in Spotlight. And then, as soon as you're done typing, use Command B, and it will jump right to Safari and do that search with your default search engine. All right, so here are two more things that Spotlight does that you may not know about. First is that you can activate menu items from it. So you can go to the menu, of course, or use keyboard shortcuts and activate a menu item. But you may not remember where it is. So I'm going to select the text, and then I'm going to use Spotlight, and I'm going to search for strike through. And notice one of the results there has this little menu bar icon there, and it even shows the app. And if I were to press return to use it, you could see it executes that menu item. And here's another cool thing that Spotlight does. It has a history of everything you've searched for. So I'm going to use Command Space, and I'm going to use the up arrow. And it's going to show me the last thing I searched for. And I'm going to continue to use up arrow to see what else I searched for recently. And you can just keep going back. So if you've already typed out something long and you searched for it before, you could use the up arrow just to get right back to it. And I'm going to finish by going into settings. In system settings, there are two places you should look to customize Spotlight. The first is, of course, to look in Spotlight. You've got some buttons up here to reset quick keys if you want. Also, there's that history I just showed you. You could delete the history. If you go down here, you could see all the different kinds of results you get. So for instance, if you find you're getting lots of results from the Books app or say from podcasts, and it's just getting in the way of things, you could turn these off. In addition to these items here, there are some system results. Like for instance, if you don't want to see apps or any documents or folders in Spotlight, you could turn those off. Also, it might be handy to turn off iPhone apps. That way you won't see iPhone apps next to your Mac apps and launch the iPhone mirroring app to run those. And then here's also a switch for the clipboard search. So if the clipboard items aren't coming up, you may have this turned off. This button here at the bottom is very important. If you click that and go into it, you could add files and folders to this to tell Spotlight, I don't want you to look in here. It's really handy if you've got apps that store a ton of cached information in a certain location and it's always coming up in your results for files. You could just add that to Spotlight and you'll never see results there. Now, the other place you should look is you should go to Keyboard and then click on the Keyboard Shortcuts button here. And there is an area here for Spotlight. And you can find the Command Space shortcut here and you can change it if you want. Also, you could set a keyboard shortcut that goes right to the first mode, the apps mode of Spotlight. So as you can see, Spotlight is a very powerful tool and more powerful starting with macOS Tahoe than ever before. It's worth your while to explore all the different things it can do and start using some of those to boost your productivity. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.